We are obsessed with the why question as a species. We humans, obsessed with purpose. It seems perfectly natural when presented with an object to ask various questions about it. What color is it? How much does it weigh? How did it come to be the way it is? How does it work? But not all questions are suitable for all objects. What is the color of jealousy? Might mean something to a poet, but not to a scientist. How does it work? Might seem suitable for a machine, but not for a lump of clay. But the question of purpose, which doesn't necessarily have to have an answer, is one that leaps to the front of the human mind, whether it's appropriate or not. It does work for some things. It works for any machine, anything designed by a human with an aim in mind. It's a sensible question for a tin opener, a mill wheel, a rain gauge, a telescope, a toboggan, a shoe, a bicycle. For some artifacts like a digital computer, it is a sensible question, but it has a very large number of answers because it's a very versatile machine. Other objects like a sextant has only one answer. Anyway, where human artifacts are concerned, no one has any trouble understanding the why question, what is it for? It's for whatever the designer or the manufacturer intended. For objects that are neither manufactured nor living, the question of purpose is simply inappropriate, if not downright silly. What is Ayers' rock for is as inappropriate as what is the color of jealousy. What's the purpose of the Matterhorn, sand dunes, mud, the universe, the Grand Canyon? These are not questions that should be put. It hasn't always been the case that people have refrained from questions of this sort. In medieval times, I suspect that you'd have found people struggling after serious answers to all those questions. The answers would mostly have been concerned with benefits to people. The stars are there to beautify the night sky. Streams are to provide water to quench the thirst of travelers. This obsession with purpose was especially true for living things. Animals and plants were placed here for our use. Henry Moore, in 1653, believed that cattle and sheep had only been given life in the first place so as to keep their meat fresh till we shall have need to eat them. And those animals that we can't eat were placed there, in some cases, for the purpose of elevating our morals. As late as the 19th century, the Reverend William Kirby thought that the louse was an indispensable incentive to cleanliness. Savage beasts, according to the Elizabethan Bishop James Pilkington, fostered human courage and provided useful training for war. Horseflies, for one 18th century writer, were created so that men should exercise their wits and industry to guard themselves against them. Lobsters were furnished with hard shells so that before eating them, we could benefit from the improving exercise of cracking their claws. Another pious medieval writer thought that weeds were there to benefit us. It is good for our spirit to have to work hard pulling them up. And it's not difficult to imagine this mindset finding a purpose in mountains and mud and deserts and stars. As I said in my opening, the human mind is obsessed with purpose.